Ucypher, India's first multi-gaming, multi-platform esports championship. 6 teams of 14 players each compete across 4 games. Counter-Strike Global Offensive, Dota 2, Tekken 7, and Real Cricket 17. Each team faces the other team twice in the league stage. And 3 points each are awarded to the winning team of Tekken 7 and Real Cricket 17 in each match. 5 points each are awarded to the winning teams of Dota 2 and CSGO games in a match. The top 4 teams in the league stage move to the knockout rounds. Ucypher, 6 teams, 84 cyber athletes, and a grand prize pool of 51 lakh rupees.
Talent wins games, but intelligence and teamwork win championships. My name is Aisha, and this is Ucypher, India's only multi-platform, multi-gaming, multiplayer esports championship. We've reached day 30, and today the Marksmen are going up against the Crusaders.
The competition is far away from declaring the winner, so pull up your socks and give it all to this fight. Let's go!
Kya hal hai Crusaders?
Badhiya.
Last day of Ucypher.
Yeah. Last day hai, to abhi like hamesha bolte ki aaj jeetenge aur hamesha shuruaat hi buri ho jati thi. But हाँ last दिन है तो खत्म करना है अच्छे नोट पे तो CS और Dota तो आज खत्म करेगा ही अच्छे नोट पे लाइक करना ही पड़ेगा क्रिकेट तो हमारा सेठ भाई आज है कि नहीं प्रैक्टिस दिखाओ यार आज और ओसामा भाई लास्ट दिन भाई फर्स्ट एपिसोड से बोल रहा हूँ बॉम्ब पड़ेगा भाई आज फोड़ दे
व्हाट इज दैट वन मेमोरी ऑफ Ucypher जो सबसे बेस्ट थी
बेसिकली द फिफ्थ मैच अगेंस्ट मार्क्समैन
इम्पॉसिबल इन दिस गेम
जब 14-8 डाउन होके जो कमबैक किया था सीएस टीम ने आई थिंक सो दैट वाज हमारा नहीं एटलीस्ट टूर्नामेंट का बेस्ट मेमोरी था
Ucypher की सबसे सैड मेमोरी क्या थी
सैड मेमोरी वही सेकंड गेम जब मैं बेंच हो गया था और हम हार गए आई थिंक सो मोमेंटम वहीं गिरा योद्धा से देखेंगे उनकी डोटा टीम सबसे वीकेस्ट बोल रहे थे बट दे टुक द मोमेंटम एंड बैक टू बैक 7 गेम्स जीते आई थिंक सो वहां पे मैंने एक मिस्टेक किया एंड वहां से फिर मोमेंटम गिरता गया हमारा तो आई थिंक सो मेरे सबसे वो सबसे गंदा मिस्टेक था वो ये हमें हर्ट कर रहा है अभी
एंड दैट वन थिंग दैट यू विल मिस अबाउट Ucypher
एवरीवन लाइक द होल टीम एज अ टीम एक फैमिली जैसा है तो होपफुली नेक्स्ट सीजन में अगर मुझे मिलेगा चांस तो मैं CS और Dota का तो सेम ही टीम रखूंगा
Crusaders यू गाइस आर वन ऑफ द बेस्ट एथलीट्स इन इंडिया राइट नाउ बिकॉज़ यू आर हियर एंड यू गाइस आर नोन एज साइबर एथलीट्स
या
आपको उस नाम से जाना जाएगा आज से सो बी प्राउड ऑफ दैट एंड हैव फन टुडे या
यस
ऑल द बेस्ट
Marksmen,
yes.
With 86 points, you guys are just, what, 14 points away from the 100 mark, which you have promised us. And today might be that day. If you clean sweep Marthio against the Crusaders, you might just reach 100. And that will make the semis a lot easier for you. Mm. Right? So while you guys are in a great mood because you know that you are going to go to the semis, let me remind you that any shift in the points table right now could be heavy on the other teams. And up tak sari teams points ke liye lad rahi hai. They've been fighting 4 points, but the Crusaders today are going to be fighting to prove a point. They all have to show the entire country why they deserve to be here. So they're going to be playing with a different vibe. Right now, while last time you guys only lost CS against them, yeah. This time we're looking for a clean sweep. But I believe you guys are missing a CS player.
Yeah, so I'm resting Rix because he's kind of unwell, and before the semi-finals, I want my best player to, you know, be pretty hooked on and, you know, fit.
Right.
So that's why I'm resting him, and Sumit will be playing today.
All right. The Marksmen are going to be killing the Crusaders softly in this day of Ucypher. All the best, guys. Good luck. Come on. Tekken 7 is a gorgeous game to watch. And while there are lots of unbelievable weapons and combos, there are also some realistic ones. That's because the creator of Tekken, Katsuhiro Harada-san, is trained in 3 different martial arts himself. karate, judo, and taekwondo. So let's warm up and have a look at the rules before we start this battle.
Players apne character select karenge. Har round mein jiska HP khatam ho jayega, wo round haar jayega. Har match ek race hai 3 rounds jeetne ki. Aur jo player pehle 3 matches jeetega, wo banega Tekken 7 ka winner. Let the battle begin.
Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, for the last time on Ucypher, Checkmate versus Ozzy.
Hello and welcome back to Tekken 7 between the Crusaders and the Marksmen. On Crusaders we have Ozzy and on Marksmen we have Devraj.
Round 1. Fight.
Well, Ozzy, first time picking up Kazumi and a good reversal from him. Nice, and now nice, he looks like nice. Dragunov is angry and pulling off all the combos. He is just going in, not giving a single chance to Ozzy. Now Ozzy stuck into the quarters. He is low on HP, now has the rage art, but now he is out of the quarters. And that is going to be a perfect one for the first round.
Round 2. Fight.
Well, Kazumi gets a nice move on Dragunov. Now going low on HP, but now replying back into the game. Dragunov with a good combo on Kazumi. Looks like it's going to be a 10-hitter combo on him. And a good block, but still stuck into the corners. Does have the rage up, but not much time to execute it. And he goes down.
Round 3. Fight.
A good uppercut from Dragunov. Again, he is going for the 10-hitter combo, making Kazumi go low on HP and stuck into the corners. And that huge hit from Dragunov. And that is going to be a knockout. Marksmen win match number 1, 3-0.
Round 1. Fight.
Looks like a character change coming in for the Crusaders. Ozzy again going back on Kuma. Starts with a bear hug, but now going in for the combo, but blocked from Dragunov. Dragunov is 50% low on his HP, but now he is going to take some serious damage, but replying back as well. Kuma now has the rage art. Well, he pulls the rage art, and yes, it does connect. And looks like it's going to be a knockout for Dragunov.
Round 2. Fight.
Well, the round 2 begins, and a good slam to the head, like Dragunov. Putting some lot of pressure on Kuma. Kuma going low on HP. Now to the corners, pulls the rage out, and yes, it does connect. But it is still gonna leave Dragunov on a huge HP lead compared to Kuma. And with a single hit, he is gonna knock him off.
Fight.
A good start of the game, blocking really well both of these players. Now Dragunov going in for the low hit, but nice read from Kuma. Now he is trying to build up pressure over Dragunov, but Dragunov is not gonna make this easy for him as well. And Kuma with good blocks and a good reversal again. So amazing move from Kuma. Well, Kuma now has the rage art. He can pull it on any time. But Dragunov stuck into the corners. And looks like if it does connect, it's gonna be a knockout. And yes, it is. He is already lost. Goes for the home run and knockout.
Round 4. Fight.
A good block from Dragunov at the start, but not for the second one. Like a good slam from both of the players, and Dragunov going huge with his combos. And now Kuma stuck into the corners. Not a single chance given to him to come back in the game. Now he has the rage out on him. Well, it does not connect, and he is gonna face a knockout.
Final round. Fight.
Well, Dragunov starting off with a good mid hits to Kuma. And now, good blocks from Kuma as well. He's trying to read the game, but not really well because he is going low on HP. But now, it looks like it's going to be a knockout for him. But looks like a comeback coming in from Kuma. Well, Dragunov is going to get knocked out with that bear hug. Crusaders win match number 2, 3-2.
Round 1. Fight.
Well, a good counter from Kuma at the start of the round. And now Dragunov with nice mid-hit and Kuma going low on his HP. Again, a nice smash to the head. And now he is low on HP. He does have the rage art. And that is going to be a knockout.
Fight.
Round 2 begins and Kuma going in for the combo. But Dragunov blocking really well But Ragnar now going low on HP. He's stuck in the corners, but now a good retreat from him. He is putting so much pressure on Kuma, going for the combos. Now pushing him to the another corner of this map. Well, a rage art pulled off from Ragnar. Well, it does connect and it's surely gonna be a knockout.
Fight.
Well, this is gonna be a whip punish. He missed the first one, and Ragnar going with that rage on him. He is not showing any mercy, and now Kuma does have the rage art on him. Right, let's see, and it's gonna be a rage art, but it's just blocked from Ragnar, and it's gonna face a knockout. The marksman win match number 3-3-0.
Round one. Fight.
Well, a nice good reversal move coming in from Dragunov. Well, he is not going to show any mercy. Going for the mid and low head, so Kuma is not blocking that. Now he is low on HP, does have the rage out. Well, he pulls it and does not connect because blocked from Dragunov. And again, a perfect coming in for the marksman.
Fight.
A nice hit on Dragunov, but that is not going to give like a huge damage on him. A good block from Dragunov. Now going for a low head, but Kuma blocked it. And there it goes, a bear hug from him. Again a good block, so now he is reading the game really well. Kuma low on HP, and there it goes, a knockout for him.
Round 3.
And this is gonna be the last round for the marksman. If they win this, they are gonna win the game. And look at that gameplay, Ragnar putting so much pressure over Kuma, but Kuma coming back into the game, not making it easy for the marksman to win this. And Kuma low on HP, just a hit away from his rage art, and there it goes. He now has the rage art. He pulls it and it does not connect. Again, it was blocked from the Dragunov. And there it goes, a knockout. So the marksmen win the game.
Devraj, congratulations for that victory. I have to congratulate you too, man. Today you won a set against Devraj. Using a character like Kuma in a competition like this.
Mera Kuma ke saath yehi hai ki abhi wo mera ye signature player ban chuka character. Jab haar raha hai pehle theek hai, lekin jab strong hoga to jo bhi character samne aayega mostly to yehi ki sabko hara dunga us ek character.
So
definitely. Wahi approach rakhna chahiye aapko. And of course, yeah, all the best.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Well, Ozzy's gotten attached to Kuma, but we've gotten attached to Ozzy. Man, it was such a pleasure to watch you play and to see your growth. Ucypher par, I think one of the greatest things we get to see is ki aap kaise enter karte ho and how you exit, right? And this is the first proper exit that we're seeing, and pure arena mein everyone's feeling a little bittersweet. We're happy for their victory and we're still sad that we're never going to see Kuma again.
Thanks to Ucypher ki mujhe mauka mila aur bahut kuch seekhne mila mujhe.
Oh man, we'll miss you, Ozzy. Ozzy, one time for Ozzy, guys. Come on.
Ozzy! Up next is a game that I have played, you have played at least once in a lifetime, and now it has come to our mobiles. I'm talking about Real Cricket 17.
ये एक batting only match है. हर player एक over face करेगा जिसमें उसे maximum runs बनाने होंगे. मैक्सिमम रन्स बनाने वाला प्लेयर मैच जीत जाएगा। टाई होने पर दोनों प्लेयर्स एक सुपर ओवर खेलेंगे टू डिसाइड द विनर।
मैम सर, अभी मैंने सुबह कहा था कि जस्ट हैव फन एंड एंजॉय एंड टेल एवरीबॉडी दैट व्हाई आर यू हियर। आप क्यों साइबर एथलीट्स हो? एंड ओजी ने वो प्रूव कर दिया। नाउ इट्स चांस फॉर किलर बी टू प्रूव इट।
आई हैव सीन सिद्धेश हिटिंग सिक्स बॉल सिक्स सिक्सेस, वैसा प्रैक्टिस में मारता ही है, बट देन यहाँ पर आके थोड़ा सा मेरे ख्याल से नर्वस हो जाता है, या स्टेज फ्राइट है जो भी है, बट देन आज मैंने उसको बोला फ्री होके खेल, जैसा भी है कुछ भी कर, अपने लिए जीत आज।
ओके, टाइम फॉर द टॉस। इफ यू विन द टॉस, क्या चाहिए आपको?
बैटिंग।
आपको?
विल चेस फर्स्ट।
फिर टॉस की जरूरत नहीं है, बिकॉज आपको चेस करना है, आपको पहले बैटिंग करनी है।
लेकिन मेरे को जीतना है टॉस।
जब जब टॉस हारे हम लोग गेम भी हारे, तो आज जीतना है टॉस।
कौन कॉल करेगा?
मैं करूँगा। हेड्स।
Heads.
Hello everyone, it's time for Real Cricket between the Marksmen and the Crusaders. And on Crusaders we have Killer B, and on Marksmen we have Thakur Rohit. The first ball comes in, And that's a huge six. It's going out of the stadium. Second ball comes in. Again, that's a good whack towards the boundary. It's a six again. And he goes again. A good shot from him. It's a six. So three balls, 18 runs. Fourth ball of the over. And that's again a good whack. It's a six. Second last ball comes in. And again towards the boundary, it's a six. So five ball, 30 runs. This is the last ball. Well, that's an amazing shot. Looks like it's going to go for a six. So six ball, 36 runs. So now the Crusaders need 37 runs to win this game. And he misses the first ball, so the Crusaders lose the game and Marksmen win it.
Last match for both of you in round robin 2, and what a fantastic finish. Congratulations for the victory. And don't lose heart, you were having fun. I saw you smile for the first time while playing.
Exactly. Like, pura main YOLO mode pe tha. Like, kuch nahi, just khelo fun ke liye aisa tha bas.
And 26 is a good score, yaar. Aapne ek point mein 7 bhi banaye the. But you came back stronger, 30, 26. I'm proud of you. And I'm sure everybody out here is proud of him. Yeah? You guys got another 3 points for your team. Hard luck, you still have 2 more games to go. Shayad, you win today's matchup.
Exactly.
The first 2 games of the day have been about breaking records and setting milestones. But our next game is going to be about breaking bones and setting off bombs. Coming up next is CSGO.
इस गेम में दो टीम्स होती हैं, एक टेररिस्ट टीम और दूसरी काउंटर टेररिस्ट टीम। ये एक टीम बेस्ड गेम है जो 5 वर्सेस 5 के फॉर्मेट में खेला जाएगा। प्लेयर्स कौन सा मैप खेलेंगे ये एक बैनिंग प्रोसेस से तय होगा। शुरुआत में दोनों टीम्स को $800 की गेम करेंसी मिलती है। The aim of the terrorist team is to plant the bomb and secure it or kill all the counter-terrorists. The aim of the counter-terrorist team is to either defuse the bomb or kill all the terrorists. इस मैच में 30 राउंड्स होंगे एंड द फर्स्ट टीम टू विन 16 राउंड्स इज द गेम विनर। इन द केस ऑफ अ टाई द रिजल्ट विल बी डिसाइडेड विद अ रेस टू 4 विन्स।
हेलो, आज रोज की तरह क्रिकेट और पेकन हार गए। ओपीसीएस पे प्रेशर है हम लोग। आज तो वैसे भी लास्ट
है, कुछ प्रेशर नहीं
है। मतलब 16-0 हारने का प्रेशर रहता है और कुछ प्रेशर नहीं है। पता है 16-0 नहीं चाहिए।
वो लोग ऑलरेडी बाहर है टूर्नामेंट से अनफॉर्चुनेटली, तो इतना प्रेशर नहीं है। हम सेकंड ही रहने वाले, हमारा पॉइंट्स पे इतना नहीं मैटर करेगा।
आज जो लोग खेलो, कैसा खेलना है खेलो, कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ता। लास्ट डे, लास्ट मैच है,
तो आज चिल करके खेलो। एक दो जो चीजें डिसाइड की थी वो प्रैक्टिस कर लेना खाली, एज अ प्रैक्टिस गेम लो। ज्यादा स्ट्रेस नहीं है, नॉर्मली खेलो। वो लोगों को जो करना है करने दो।
आज इंपेलर खेलने वाला है, मेनली नाइफ करने का ट्राई करो, नहीं हुआ तो ठीक है।
इंपेलर उनके लिए ज्यादा खतरा है हमारे से, इसलिए इंपेलर का तो मुझे इतना टेंशन नहीं है।
अनफॉर्चुनेटली अपन बाहर हो गए। अपन भले सीएस जीतेंगे आज का गेम, जो अपन जीतने वाले, अपन लाइन में 4 जीत जाएंगे अगर आज का जीते तो।
ऑल इज ऑन टारगेट, गो मार्क्समैन, टारगेट गो मार्क्समैन, टारगेट गो मार्क्समैन। उठाओ अपनी कोल्ड ड्रिंक और चलो।
Venom, it seems like after the first 2 games, the marksmen are on their way to a clean sweep. Lekin, pichli baar Crusaders ke against CSGO mein aap haar gaye the. Aaj, if you want to reach 100, you can't lose again.
Yeah, I know that because I think abhi ye revenge match hai and we want to win because agar hum aaj jeetenge and iske baad agar Dota bhi jeet jaate Data Shoot, to वो मोमेंटम कैरी फॉरवर्ड होगा सेमीफाइनल्स में। सो वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू प्ले लाइटली। हम लोग जैसे खेलते हैं वैसे ही खेलेंगे।
बट आई एम श्योर दीज गाइस टुडे आर नॉट गोइंग टू टेक दैट लाइटली, राइट? बिकॉज़ क्रिश, लास्ट टाइम द वन गेम दैट द क्रुसेडर्स वन अगेंस्ट द मार्क्समैन वाज सीएसगो, एंड आई बिलीव टुडे फॉर द सीएसगो स्क्वाड स्पेसिफिकली इट्स गोइंग टू बी अबाउट लीविंग ऑन अ हाई।
यस, सो आई हैव इन्फॉर्मड, आई हैव टोल्ड देम एवरीथिंग दैट इवन दो वी आर आउट ऑफ द टूर्नामेंट, यू गाइस फोकस ऑन योर काउंटर स्ट्राइक। लास्ट मैच है आज, आज भी हम लोगों को वही एम्स है कि हम लोगों को वी हैव टू फिनिश 4 इन अ रो। So we have to win this game today.
IGL Krish, good luck to the Crusaders and Marksmen. Put on a great show, man.
Thank you. Good luck.
A
Hello and welcome back to Counter-Strike. It's gonna be the Crusaders versus the Marksmen. And today is gonna be the last day to Counter-Strike. It's gonna be the Crusaders versus the Marksmen. And today is gonna be the last day of the Crusaders because they are not gonna go for future matches because they are the lowest team on the scoreboard. Well, it's gonna be the map Inferno, favorite map of the Marksman, and the knife round begins. Chris getting the first frag on Impaler. He is also playing this for the first time in this season. And Chris getting a frag on Venom and coming with the second frag, going in for the backstab and slicing off on. It's gonna be slow and stuck in this situation. So the Crusaders have won the knife round and they choose to play as thieves first. They want to take the advantage of the map because Inferno is quite a city-sided map. So Rex holding towards the coffins. And looks like a nice setup from the marksman towards the B bomb side. The smokes and flashes goes in and now slow it coming in onto the side, tags the player and he goes lower HP and gets a kill on Rex, and power also goes down by Slowin. So amazing hit from him and a single tap. What an easy kill for Slowin. So three kills already for Slowin, and now Kavish left in a 1-on-5 situation, but can he clutch this round for his team? He heard the player rushing towards him, gets a one tap on Slowin and another bullet to Pawn as well. So Pawn goes down and now making it a 1v3 situation for him. He is going in Impaler with a one tap and Impaler is down, and but the final frag is going to be by Veer Bhadra and winning the first round. Well, Krish is towards the mid. The players are rushing towards the alley side, but he could actually manage a frag, and yes he does. Well, Veer Bhadra goes down by the nice scout headshot. Power waiting in aggressive towards the outside. He finds one frag on to Slowin with his 5-7. And Skavish holding on to the house. He gets a kill on Pawn. So now it's gonna be a 2-on-5 situation for the marksman. But Venom gets a nice frag on Magix. He is waiting for the Crusaders to push and make a mistake. And now he goes in, rushing into the library. He gets one frag, making it a 2v3. Power coming in from library for a backstab. Well, he finds a kill on Impaler.
मेरे को पता था कि आप मैंने मेट्रोइड वाले को यहाँ से मारा है, तो पोजीशन वहाँ पे पहुँच चुकी है कि ये यहीं पे, तो ये लोग आके मेरे को प्री फायर करेंगे, मुझे स्क्रीन में दिखेगा भी नहीं, मार देंगे। वो एक्सपेक्ट करेगा कि डर के साइड पे बैठा रहेगा और मैं डर के बैठने वालों में से नहीं हूँ, तो मैंने आगे अग्रेशन दिखाया वैसे करके, मैंने आई थिंक एस मार दिया वो राउंड।
Well, the captain taking the things in his own hand and winning the round for the team. The marksmen are playing tremendously well, but even the Crusaders are trying to give a tough fight to them. So let's jump into round number 6. Well, again, looks like a setup coming towards the B side, and Krish in that small window finds the captain of the marksmen, and the flash is coming in, and Rex with a good flash. And the CZ gets a nice tap on Slowin and going for the second frag, but did a decent amount of damage. Well, it's gonna be Veer Bhadra to shut down Krish, and the players are totally flashed, and Rex with the CZ magic over here. He gets two instant kills. Rex pushing towards the alley side, and Veer Bhadra over here with his AWP. He is gonna take some little bit damage from that nade. Veer Bhadra holding in and spots the elbow of Power. He needs just a small window to shut a player down, and Venom rushing in gets a damage but still managing to shut down Rex, and Kavish through the smoke gets Impaler.
हम लोग ने B capture कर लिया था और हम लोग को shutting के दो kills भी मिल चुके थे. मैं एक player था, उसने शायद से smoke के through CT spawn से push किया और तीन लोग को डाल दिया, मतलब तीन लोग को मार दिया उसने. तो फिर वो Venom को उसमें मतलब MF हो गया कि 5-on-3 कैसे round जा सकते करके, तो उसमें वो पहले से tilt था, ऊपर से और हो गया, तो उसके वजह से फिर उसने सीधा बोल दिया कि मैं solo खेल रहा हूँ, तुम लोग को जैसा खेलना वैसा खेल लो.
Well, magic, what an amazing round from him. Gets goes in and gets 3 instant kill, and Kavish shuts the last guy, going to be slow in, and now taking a 1-round lead. So it's gonna be 7-4, the Crusaders are playing really well. And Power, that shot to Veer Bhadra, just like a revenge for the previous shot that he did on him. And Slowin through the boilers with a smoke, but Krish is gonna shut it down. a huge rush coming in from them, and Chris going aggressive as well. Sprays and prays, but only managing to get one frag and instantly traded by Impaler. But Power as well comes with a nice backup and trades him really fast. So now it's going to be a 3-on-4 situation. And slow in moving towards the arch, but it's going to be Kavish already waiting there for a backstab. And there it goes. Slow in goes down. Now it's going to be Rex boosting Magic's over here. Magic doesn't know there's a player below him. And well, he spots him. Venom goes down. The captain is down. And now it's going to be Veerbhadra with his AWP. And he couldn't connect any shot. So Crusaders 9-6 the first half. A 3-round lead on them. Crusaders are playing really well, though it's their last match for this tournament, and let's see how is going to be their gameplay after the side switch. Well, Krish pushing aggressive towards the apartments. Well, he finds Impaler with a good shot, and Stone did a damage on Magic. Well, Rex going into the side just like a Hail Mary rush, and he gets a kill on Pawn. Kavish holding here for a backstab towards the library. He gets Veerbhadra. An amazing shot from him. Now it's gonna be Slowin and Venom versus the Crusaders. A 2-on-4 situation with a nice jiggle peek. Rex shuts Slowin down and Chris going for the next frag. Crusaders win the next round. So Crusaders are not giving a single chance to the Marksmen to come back into this game. And now it's time for round number 22. Veerbhadra just going in aggressive with his AWP, shuts down Power. So there's no voltage left now, and now he misses the second shot, and he's going still aggressive.
मेरे पास एक flash था, मैंने B पे एक pop flash किया और सीधा B rush करने का try किया, तो मेरे को upper full blind मिला था, तो मैंने उसको मार दिया. उसके बाद Venom ने फिर भी fight लिया अकेला था, तो मैंने उसको मेरे P250 से मार दिया.
Well, Rex giving a huge economical damage to the marksman over here, and AWP and Assaulter are already down towards the alley side. Well, he did plant the C4 now and is gonna play aggressive, and Impaler is already down, so now making it a 2v1 situation. Rex with that pop flash couldn't do much, and Pawn shuts him down. Are making a comeback into the game. The economy for the Crusaders have been destroyed, and they are on eco right now. But we see a few upgrade pistols like Deagles and all, and Slowin rushing in just manages to get one kill through that spray and instantly traded. But Pawn holding a nice angle gets a kill through the smoke and the second one as well. He is just going crazy, and the third frag as well through the smoke.
Nice one.
So now the Crusaders are on match point. Power shuts down Slowin, and Magic kills Veerbhadra and the second frag as well to Venom. The alley is now clear for them, and Bombsite B can be entered easily. But Magic's going aggressive, low confident from his side. He goes down by Pawn and Impale coming in from mid. He gets Power, making it a 2-on-3 situation. Pawn goes in, gets a frag on Krish. So Pawn is just on fire right now, gets down Rex as well. It's gonna be 1-on-2 situation. Kavish is just holding a good angle, shuts down Pawn and Impaler as well, and the Crusaders win the last game of their tournament.
Crusaders का unfortunately last match है आज. Atul बहुत अच्छा captain है and मेरा अच्छा friend भी है, तो मुझे उसके लिए बुरा लग रहा है. उन्हें मैं all the best कहना चाहूँगा, and I hope next season में वो अच्छी team build करे, and I think top 4 या top 2 तो definitely है, क्योंकि वो इंसान अच्छा है and मैं उसे miss करूँगा.
And that game of CS:GO ended with 16-11 points in the favor of the Crusaders. Remstar, your CS:GO squad really killed it today, man. I think this was Kavish's third MVP, yeah. Right? And he's also the third highest fragger, if that's a term, of Ucypher so far. I believe they're going out on a high, man.
Yeah, they were playing good. Last four matches, they have won back-to-back, and all were close games. But this one, they closed it down like pretty good. Kavish is getting the highest frags, but if you see today's game, everyone, all five of them contributed.
Absolutely. I mean, I know for a fact that after the kind of performances they've been putting up, all our CSGO fans out there are going to miss each and every one of them, all of them. Man, I hate saying goodbye to them after this, especially after this. Venom, I'd like to mention that this has cost you the 100-point mark which you were aiming for today. Dur nahi hai, lekin in logo ne aapke liye thoda mushkil kar diya hai. You guys have got 5 points so far, and with another 5 points which you can hope to make from your next game in Dota 2, you could actually win today.
Yeah, from the past 3 matches, we are winning CS but then losing Dota. I don't know why, but today is like the last game and I've decided that I'm going to do everything today. So hopefully today 5 points we are going to take and at least win our first face-off in the last match.
Absolutely, man. On this high note, congratulations and all the best.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Ucypher and Sport, Nai Superstars. After the game 3, the Marksmen are at 6 and Crusaders are at 5. Up next, we have the last game of the day, Dota 2.
Dota 2 mein har player apne liye ek hero select karenge. Is game mein do teams compete karengi in a 5 versus 5 format. Har hero ke paas special powers aur abilities hoti hai. हर टीम का ऑब्जेक्टिव है अपने एंशियंट्स को डिफेंड करना और अपने ओपोनेंट के सारे टावर्स को डिस्ट्रॉय कर देना। जो टीम पहले एनिमी टीम के डिफेंस को तोड़कर उनके सारे टावर्स डिस्ट्रॉय कर देगी, वो टीम जीतेगी।
Versus the Crusaders is underway here at Ucypher Season 1, and already on the top lane we see Itachi got in a bit of trouble. Bakemono coming in invincible with the poof. They will score first blood as Senjin claims bonus intelligence on that silencer.
Itachi got, he's looking for some sort of response. They have the boundless strike, they catch the meepos, but the damage this early on might not be enough. Invincible with the micro trying to keep one meepo alive, and here comes Tosh in the ravages there. They find mage, they might look for more. Fashu along with Red, and Itachi got a dropping low, but Red has to press the attack that's going to keep him healthy. The Razzle unfortunately will end up falling. The chase is still on. Red trying to salve and run away. Itachi got making a run further east, seems to get away, but here comes Remstar on the wiper with the wiper strike. Itachi got looking for the deny, will not find it. Remstar finds the kill while the rest of them are busy chasing this Legion commander. Red trying to make it back to his own shrine. If he gets there, he can tag it. It is still active, but the last word is enough and Senjin finds the kill.
9 minutes in, they're going to go into the jungle. They see Red farming here, trying to get closer to his blink dagger. They'll catch him with the boulder smash and the nets. The poofs were there as well. The shrine doesn't keep him alive.
Senjin on a killing spree. A lot of early intelligence going towards the silencer. And Crusaders, they're looking for some sort of an early push. Just 17 minutes in, they don't have much of an advantage, but they'll start pounding away on tier 3. They want to end early before this Huskar becomes fat. They found the Dazzle, who grazed himself, might end up falling. The press the attack is there. Viper strike onto the Huskar. You got the boundary strike controlling the meepos, but not for long enough. Invincible on a killing spree. What's the plan here for the Marksman? Zarg can't really man fight this meepo, but with the Wukong's command, they might be able to. The Ravages there, they'll take away the Aegis. Darshan just hanging around in the Wukong's command, and Remstar will end up falling to the Monkey King as Mage cleans up and brings down the Earth Spirit as well. Senjin and Darshan looking to run. Invincible trying to micro, not being successful. The duel is there. They've caught one of the meepos and Invincible. He's trying his best to stay alive. Does manage to survive the duel. Itachi got chasing for more. Finds the silencer. Mage doesn't even need to chip in. He finds a triple kill while Red finds the meepo as well.
That was a successful defense coming out from the Marksman, and it could be the time that Crusaders has warning bells ringing. Meanwhile, middle lane, Invincible jumps in, kills off Red in a quick pickoff. There's the turnaround, Mage comes in, the boundless strike was there, the Wukong's command on the floor. Can he survive through all of this? Looks like he can't. That was ambitious.
Nice! Bottom lane, Parshu just gonna TP out towards mid, where Pakimono clips him with the boulder smash.
Last Dota game of round robin 2, and the Crusaders are on a path to their first match victory, yeah?
Exactly, Crusaders are playing amazing.
You know, I feel Crusaders today are playing like real champions.
Finally.
Because they know they have nothing to lose. They know that they're already out, but they're here to prove a point.
Yep.
Senjin needs to be careful. Zark just jumps on top of him with the life break. The last word controlling him, the Ravage as well. They got the Nether Toxin, and that break might just be enough to bring down the Husker. But he gets the press, the attack. It's not going to keep him alive, but it's going to allow him to just delay the inevitable. Itachi Gordo might not be that lucky. Invincible finds not one, but two kills. One on the Legion Commander who dueled him, and one on the Night Stalker who got too close for comfort.
22 minutes in, 19-7. They're going back to finish what they started on the bottom lane. Invincible comes in, catches the Monkey King behind and brings him down. The barracks are in jeopardy. The global silence has been dropped. Bakemono goes in, gets the Magnetizer off onto the Night Stalker. He's the only one that's been tagged by it. He's been graved up as well for now. Behind though, he's got the duel coming out. Itachi God running to the farm, ends up going down nonetheless. It's 21-8 and the barracks have fallen on the bottom lane.
Invincible just sieging high ground here with his clones, goes forward, Hex is one, the Ravage is there, but the Grave controlling the Hex target. Darshan needs to be careful, the Wukong's command does do a fair bit of work. They manage to take down the Husker. Pakimono is dropping low, will end up falling. Zark buys back in the midst of this. Now they've taken away the Aegis from the Meepo. This is the chance for the Marksman to press forward. Invincible though, he's still a force, he brings down one, but Zark man fights with the Grave. Finds the Meepo, finds the Tide, and Red is looking for more. He doesn't have the duel, but he can chase with the Blink Dagger. Remstar turns to fight, drops the Nether Toxin, might just end up going down, and Parshu ends up picking up that kill for himself. The Marksmen, they defend high ground, but they do lose their tier 3.
Once again, you've got Remstar and Co. trying to breach high ground. The Ravage is there to disrupt the duel this time around. He's trying to fight his way through all of this. The Wukong's command dropped on the floor. Mage using that high ground to try and fight through. Darshan ends up going down behind his Zark, but behind Invincible has brought down Mage. The buyback comes out from the Legion Commander, but it's too little too late. There's three down on the side of the Radiant. Remstar comes in from behind as well. It's just the Legion Commander left alive, and he's about to go down as well. Crusaders have essentially team wiped the Marksmen and are looking to take barracks.
There should be at least another lane of barracks. They've already taken two sets of barracks. They're just going to go for the throne. The Marksmen have tapped out Crusaders, causing one of the biggest upsets in Season 1 of Ucypher.
We haven't associated the Marksmen with the word defeat too often in this league, but this was a tough pill to swallow because you came up against the Crusaders, who are outside the top four. You guys are clearly one of the favorites to go ahead and bag the title. But a loss with them winning both the big ones, you won Cricket and Tekken, you lost CS and Dota to the Crusaders. This one must hurt.
Yeah, it's hurting because the strategies what we planned, we couldn't execute them pretty well in the game, and that's what hurt us, and yeah. You know, we lost the game.
Was there a case of maybe just being a little too overconfident coming in, knowing that they're outside the top four, you sort of clearly are the favorites coming in?
I would say for the Dota guys, I could sense that, but for the CS, we were trying new strategies also. Right. So because we were in the top four and the upcoming matches were pretty difficult for us, so we wanted to execute few things and see how the strategies would work in the next games.
Well, I guess it's a good time to try things, right? I mean, you're still comfortably in the top four. In some ways, this was the team to try it against. Are you still okay with the fact of how things are panning out?
Yeah, that's why I tried. I took this risk because we were in the top four and they were anyways not qualifying. So. If I had done this in the semi-finals, it would have hurt us a lot more. But right now, we know what went wrong, so we can, you know, kind of correct our mistakes and take it forward from there.
As you said, there's plenty of time to take it forward. You guys are really marching forward. I know it's a small blip in your campaign, but the Marksmen are marching ahead towards the semi-finals in pretty good nick, apart from this little blip.
The Marksmen are at 6 and the Crusaders have ended with 10 points, which means day 30 has ended in a resounding victory for the Crusaders. Although this will be their first victory, this will also be their last. Kyunki wo log itne points nahi bana paaye to rise up in the leaderboard. Have a look. What makes a captain great is not that he possesses power, but that he has the ability to empower others. Or Ucypher Pay, we are not only hunting for the best team, but also the best captain.
You know, a great captain is a captain who will always stand by his team, and he knows the weaknesses and strengths of all his teammates. He'll inspire the team and he'll always lead the team from the front. And that's exactly what we witnessed today. Remstar and Crusaders got their first match victory, even though they're not in the championship, but they have gone home with a lot of respect. If you want to watch today's entire gameplay, you can log on to usports.in. Tomorrow, we have the first match of a semi-final between the Akramaks and the Yakshas. That is going to be very, very interesting. Only on Ucypher, Naya Sport, Naya Superstars, a Usports initiative. My name is Varun.
And my name is Aisha.
Do Ucypher.
जो आज ये मैच जीतेगा वो ग्रैंड फिनाले ऑफ यूसाइफर में जाएगा
आज टफ कंपटीशन है मुझे नहीं लगता है
कुछ भी हो जाए हिस्ट्री बनने वाली है
शेखर इज आल्सो अ गुड लर्नर बट आई हैव ग्रेट काउंटर्स फॉर दैट एज वेल
आज कंसंट्रेशन से हटना नहीं मुझे इसलिए कुछ बोलूंगा नहीं
What could possibly come as a surprise for you guys?
हम लोग हारेंगे तो वो सरप्राइज रहेगा